it's happening in New York, New Jersey, or Long Island, hear about it with Joe Piscopo. Mornings, 6 to 10 on AM 970. The Answer.
Hey, did you catch a cough on the plane? You okay?
I got the cough on the plane, actually. But you know, I just saw these guys in Berlin, right?
Yeah, that was the best. But listen to Arthur Idala. You go to Berlin. You were just in Berlin like last week. When did I talk to you last?
June.
You went to Berlin with buddies to go see the Stones in Berlin, which must have been exciting.
Joe, you could appreciate this. I mean, Charlie Watts, the drummer, is 77. Now, I've been to your shows multiple times.
Yeah.
I watch you play one song.
Yeah.
And that's no easy task. This guy played 20 songs.
77 years old. Mick but Charlie Keith, looked 77 back in 1968.
I know, but he's still
God
up there.
God bless him.
And Mick and Keith is 75.
You know what's amazing?
Is
it not amazing that let them go? God bless them. Godspeed. You know, Mick is in incredible shape.
Unbelievable. Excuse me. The guy didn't stop.
Got a 2-year-old? Or a 1-year-old?
Well, yeah.
I'm just saying.
Arthur, doesn't matter.
There's hope for some of us.
But listen, Joe, you already got all of that going on.
I know. So the Stones were great. Did they speak in German? Did they say anything in German?
No, but they were, you know what was interesting? Because you would appreciate this. They started off playing Street Fighting Man, and it was awesome, right? It was a ton of energy. Then they played It's Only Rock and Roll, and the energy kind of went down a little bit, and I looked at my buddy. I was like, all right, you know, they're losing it. And then, Joe, it was off to the races. They played Tumbling Dice. They jammed it for like 12
and
minutes.
Running around
like he's 29, 30. Yeah.
Is he 74 or something like that?
75. He's just turning this year.
I love it.
That's why I went to Berlin, and that was awesome, and you get to disconnect a little bit. But then I just did 2 weeks in Italy, in Sicily specifically, and I turned off my email.
Where were
you,
Al? Where were you?
I was in San Diego.
Where'd you go to? You went to Clark, didn't you? Downtown Clark.
But that's where I go. What you mentioned in the earlier hour about, well, first of all, yesterday when I heard you say, oh, everyone loves Trump, and I was like, wow, Joe fell on his head because, you know, in Manhattan, everyone doesn't love Trump, right? And as you say, you used the term earlier, the Northeast Corridor.
Yeah, man.
Like, everyone doesn't love. I mean, God forbid you wear. People have given me a hard time for wearing my red, white, and blue stuff. Oh, what are you, a patriot? I'm like, yeah, of course I'm a. What are you, crazy? Mm. But now there's been this, like, if you're a patriot, you're with Trump and you want to hold kids away from their parents. And talking about getting out of the Northeast Corridor, I'm in the middle of Palermo, like, eating a rice ball and drinking red wine for breakfast. And you know what you do, Joe? You realize what's important.
Yeah, that's right.
And what's not.
I'm there
with my mother, my father, my sister,
you want with
my
the whole
brother-in-law,
family. Look at
my
you.
Niece,
Look
my
at
nephew, you. My oh, wife, my obviously, Marianne, Luca, and Arthur.
Luca went to that.
And
great,
I shut everything down because, Joe, when you really look around, there's not one email, there's not one phone call that's more important than that.
Yeah.
And with the inundation of cable television and the radio and the cover of the New York Post, how the iPhones are ruining our eyes because we're always on these phones. Mm. We forgot about the things that made Americans great, which is us, our family,
our lives,
our interactions, speaking to each other. And it's a wonderful thing. And then driving in, Frank, to your point, and it's a huge point that Dershowitz says over and over again. The Justice Department is not supposed to be used to go after political enemies for sport. Obviously, if people are accepting bags of cash to vote a certain way, or bags of cash, or an airplane, or a villa in France to give someone a particular contract, yes, they should be prosecuted. But we have gone way beyond.
Hasn't it always been like that, though, Arthur?
It has, but it's gotten worse than that.
Yeah.
I mean, look, the obvious thing was Clinton and Whitewater and Vince Foster and all of that. Mm. So I will tell you, in Italy, though, in general, they're pretty fond of Trump.
Yeah. Is that right?
Yep. In general.
So you went to Palermo? Were you in Palermo?
They say he's crazy. They're like, ma lui è pazzo. My bravo.
Yeah, yeah.
He's nuts, but,
bro,
he's good.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yeah. I said, you know what? I said, different issues. It's people have different opinions. I was right outside of Palermo, and then I was in a tiny town, Joe, called Castel. The area's called Castel del Mare del Golfo, and the town's called San Vito Lo Capo. And the beauty is, in today's day and age, look, I'm 50. I have two kids. I have two parents who are in their beautiful golden years. I got a lot on my plate, as do you.
Mm.
And we forget to just disconnect and just and appreciate what's right in front of us.
You go to Palermo. I go to LBI. You go to Palermo. Yeah.
Listen, Joe, the only thing stopping you is your fear and your crazy idiosyncrasy. You'd get on the plane and you'd give them this stuff that you have there.
Durasan.
Yeah, the Durasan. You say, could you put this Durasan in the air that blows
it? I have to tell you, Durasan, but thank you for bringing it up, Arthur. When you know when you take out the table in the plane, what's the most?
They say that's the dirtiest thing is that pocket,
on Earth.
Right, right.
On Earth is the.
I know.
The,
my
the,
wife is.
So
Marianne's
I put
like,
it out. I Durasan the whole thing. Bang! I feel great. I'm telling
Marianne
you.
Marianne carries the wipes.
Yeah, yeah. The wipes are good too. Durasan has wipes.
And she's wiping the whole thing. Yeah. I mean,
on the plane,
again, Joe. You always refer to the greatest generation, right?
Yeah, man.
And that's who I think of. And we are such a bunch of wimps.
Yeah, yeah. You're
you
right.
Think my grandfather Artie Idalo or my other grand Frank Riazza, they were happy to eat.
They came over.
Kelly Conway.
Boat. Let me sterilize this.
Kellyanne Conway said it when you and I were in Washington.
She was great.
Our grandparents were just so happy to have a roof over their head and food on the table. Yeah. We have taken that to such a different degree. It's got to be. Look at you. You eat the maple syrup over here. It's got to be a certain kind.
And
your grandparents were happy to eat.
I know.
But that they're going wrong for potatoes and eggs. It was the cheapest thing on the planet. I know. But they had it.
The quote-unquote peasant food. Hey, by the way, you were great down there. We didn't even talk in detail about that. That was great down the White House. You jacked that whole thing up because I knew where I was going. You brought Rudy
help.
Up. Arthur, I didn't need some help.
No. I don't need support, not help. You were doing a great job.
I know where I'm going. You just went there. And it could have been a train wreck. You could have caused a train wreck. You handled it meticulously.
Joe, you're singing. There's Rudy to your right. And he's like jumping up and down in his seat. He's dying to come up with
and,
you.
And
Kellyanne is next to me, swaying back and forth. The ambassador to Italy.
And I got in my head, I'm going there. Let me finish the verse. Of course, like Arthur only does too well, you jumped right in. But the timing was great. But the most magnificent thing you did was with the Mike Pompeo picture. That was great. Well, anybody who said, Arthur grabbed the camera and said, Mr. Secretary, can we have a picture of you and Joe? Boom, took a picture of me and Mike Pompeo and his wife. That was great. Quick, you didn't say, oh, do you mind if I jump in?
Well, number one, that's you not my role. I just got to go back and correct something.
That would be
everyone who's listening. Yeah. Joe Piscopo doesn't need help with anything. I can never help him. He is the best. And I misspoke when I said Joe needed help. I just meant he needed like support because everybody was there and wanted to be with Joe. And I know you well enough that you would welcome everybody up on the stage.
The jury will disregard Mr. Idalo's prior comments.
Thank you, Ryo. I've gone down this road before. It's not a pleasant road. You got to get called to the carpet. Murano called you. Listen, Joe wasn't real happy. You made a little comment. You know, so I don't want to be in that doghouse. It's tough enough living, you know, trying to be a good husband and a good father. I got to be a good Piscopo servant. You know, we all been there. Gattulo's just sitting there nodding. He's like, oh, yeah, I feel your pain, Idala. You don't want to cross.
This thing, Arthur, he's like, Gattulo's the guy that runs the whole machine. Are you kidding me?
Trust me, I know that.
He's the glue, right, Frankie? He's the glue.
Kirk Enterprise.
You like that?
Kirk Enterprise.
You at least see what
Joe,
I got.
I will correct you. I don't think there's anyone on the planet who would refer to Al Gattulo as svelte.
No.
Come on.
He may have lost some pounds.
He
should get credit.
Did.
I got him back. I gained him back.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean, but.
I'm going on a detox next month.
I would like us to go to Italy. Do you know the trip we would have?
Do you hear the silence in the room when you said that?
No, because one of us, there's a likelihood.
Yeah, but there's no way the station will ever sponsor anything
like
that.
One of us will get arrested. One of us will lose their money. Okay?
And I'll get married and have three children.
Probably.
Here's why you're wrong. In Italy, Italy's more like America was in the 50s. They only arrest you. Like when Joe was running around in Jersey doing bad things, the cops would grab him, kick him in the butt, and say, go home and I better never see you again.
Right.
Now in New York, they just put the handcuffs on
you.
It's the same way in
Except
Italy.
Except if you smoke pot.
They really don't want to, they really don't want to arrest anyone. There's not a ton of gambling in Italy.
No, I didn't mean he'd lose it from gambling. He'd get pickpocketed.
Oh, okay.
Oh, without a doubt.
And Joe would basically sing our way through Italy. Everywhere we go, he'd sing a song. The meals would be calm.
I'm going a year from September. I'm going on a cruise throughout the Greek islands, and we're going.
That's unbelievable.
We're going to Naples and to Rome.
That's spectacular.
So we'll be.
Murano has to go. He would be in his element.
He doesn't want to leave Staten Island.
I know.
This guy.
Believe me. That's not true.
When I'm eager to go.
When I hear him say his next weekend, Joe, I'm going away next weekend. I'm like, oh, good. Where's he going to go? Is he going to go to Colorado? Is he going to go to Denver? Is he going to go to San Diego? Yeah, we're going to go. We're trying out a new hotel in Atlantic City. One of the smartest guys who I respect the most. He does not have the...
You want to go to the island of Capri, he goes to the island of Staten. Like, that's it.
You know what, though? When you're in New York, you're exposed to all these different international cultures.
It's not the same.
I hear you.
I've been to Japan. I've been to Africa.
I love two people go to Epcot. They go to Epcot. Like, oh, I'll go to Epcot.
Yeah, and, I'm going to go to Italy tonight. I'll go to Mexico tomorrow.
You know, Joe, since you brought it up, and it doesn't need a plug, but it was a guest on your show, I did, from Italy, because a lawyer recommended, I bought one ticket to go see The Originalist about Justice Scalia.
With Ed Giro.
And
Joey Falcon, my friend, I got to go. You're going Friday?
I'm hoping to go Friday.
My parents are going Friday.
This is Ed Giro doing...
Justice Scalia.
An incredible portrayal of Antonin Scalia.
Hires a young African-American law clerk to be his sparring partner. She's a staunch liberal. And he said, I'm hiring you just to keep me intellectually. And
that's, you remember this? Do you remember when the judge did that? Do you remember?
I don't remember doing that, but I will tell you this.
Arthur was very close with the judge.
He was Ed was spectacular to the point, Joe, when he came out after the show, I waited for him. I started crying a little bit because he had Miss Justice Scalia down. The words that came out of his mouth, his gestures, his mannerisms. And then when I got home and I went online and I hadn't been around for 2 weeks, I started researching him. I find out he was on your show the week before.
Yeah.
I'm like, why is he retweeting all of Murano's stuff? I go, he knows Murano. And then I kept digging deeper, and I saw he was on the show. Joe, it is very... I know how valuable your time is.
I know. I'm
but
going.
It is so
I'm looking
well
here.
Worth
it's
it.
Called The Originalist, and if you...
It's an hour and a half.
Yeah,
and
this is
it's
great.
It's about some of his biggest decisions and how he achieved them and how he just applied the law based on the words that were in the Constitution. And if you wanted to change him, that's Congress's job. That's not the Supreme Court.
Look at the texts I get from my friends, Joey. Now he's got Ed Giro as the Originalist, and then two texts later, Broccoli Rob.
Well, listen, Giro's very Italian. Scalia in the show, he's very Italian. In real life,
well, you know,
he's
we'll
very
get
Italian.
The information for you because there's a theater, and I should have the information. It's on
59 East 59th.
Oh,
the
God.
Originalist.
Look at you.
59
look at you.
East 59th.
Beautiful. Thank you, Arthur Idella. Arthur, welcome home.
Thank
Let's
you.
Put together a trip to Italy. Let's all go.
Bro, I'll spearhead the whole thing.
All right. Well, if we don't go to Italy, we go to Dino and Harry's in Hoboken?
Yeah, something like that.
Said, okay.
Or at least Michael's in Brooklyn.
Everybody knows this guy. Now, everybody knows he can do a radio show. Joe Piscopo. Mornings, 6 to 10 on AM 970. The Answer.